Commanders. Commanders.
Commanders.
We fight for all DC. Who are we?
The Commanders.
Commanders. Commanders.
Left hand up. Who are we? Commanders. All right, that's enough about that. Yeah, we did it again. They didn't believe in us. A little bit less of an underdog in Arizona, but Washington won again. I didn't think it could get better than it did last week, but, you know, this was even sweeter. It's like I said from the jump. Gotta draft Jaden Daniels. He's a generational talent. No, you all know I didn't say that. You all know I wanted Marvin Harrison Jr. And you know what? I was wrong. Which leads me into my first point. Well, actually, let's go back. Let's do our intros. Welcome to the Week 4 Fantasy League of Extraordinary People. Underground, super underground podcast. Super secret. Probation underdog podcast. What is that line from Animal House? It's Animal House, right?
Then as of this moment, they're on double secret probation.
That's right. Double secret probation. That's right. That's our podcast. I guess it's a podcast. It's just a recording. We're not putting it on iTunes yet, although I'm thinking about doing it. Whoa. Elton John, be quiet. I don't know why that started. See, it's janky. This is why we're not ready for primetime yet. Elton John just magically comes on the computer. I mean, I love you. I love your music. Sir Elton John. It's incredible. Documentary coming out this December that looks pretty good. I don't get any money from Elton John for this or his people. This is our Fantasy Football League of Extraordinary People. Easy for me to say. Week 4 recap show. You guys asked for it, so I'm bringing it back. You guys can... What do we got in store? We got a new parody song at the end of the episode. We're going to go through all our recaps. And hopefully, it's like we said before. Hopefully, even other people that listen to the podcast, which I know are not that many other people, but there are some, maybe they will get some good fantasy nuggets of info that they may like or be able to take to their fantasy teams. And, you know, you guys play in other leagues. Maybe it'll help you guys play in some of the other leagues that you're playing in. Parody song will also drop in tomorrow night's episode. It could be Thursday morning's episode of In This League. That's at In This League with Bogman and the Welsh, my favorite guys. I listen to them. I never miss football, baseball, all their betting stuff, although I don't do much betting. I just do the fantasy. But the betting is important. So you can get fantasy information even from the betting stuff because it's like, oh, that person might have a better singular day this day. So maybe it's a good one-week replacement for somebody. You know, little things like that can help give you the edge. Anyways, back to the Washington theme song there. That was One Hand Up Were the Commanders by... Can't find it. Uh-oh. Bad. There we go. That's Oh Goody featuring Big 57. I just wanted to make sure I got their names correct there. We're not going to edit that out. We're just going to keep rolling. Okay, well, anyways, my mom sent me the new fight song lyrics to the old Hail to the Hmm-Hmm. They changed it to Hail to the Commanders. And I think, honestly, it could have been done better. If you read the comments on this one page, it's the same things that my mom said. Like, it's like the lyrics are fight for our commanders, so they're fighting for themselves. This replaces the line, Braves on the warpath. I don't know. We could do better. Just like my mom said, she wrote her own lyric that was better. And, you know, my mom is a talented songwriter and parody songwriter too in her own right, so of course it would be better than this little thing. I mean, honestly, we probably should have just scrapped the whole... You can't fit a different song, like a different name, into another song that already exists. You're always going to think of that old song. You need to do a new song, start your own thing. That's just my opinion, of course. But if you're listening to this, you know it's just my opinion, which brings me back to my first point, which was accountability. Now, again, I said that I would have preferred Marvin Harrison Jr., but I don't really watch a lot of college football, and all I know is that Washington usually makes bad drafting decisions, and it looks like this time they finally hit gold, and I'm so happy to be wrong. I'm happy to be wrong, and that's what I'm trying to say. Guys, you know I've never won this league. I don't think so. We've been playing this league for 1,000 years. I've never won, so, like, what do I know? I just like talking football. So I just want to be like, you know, clear as day here. I might sound opinionated, or I sound like I know what I'm talking about, or maybe I don't, because I don't. I'm just guessing, like all of you guys and so many of the other analysts out there. Accountability. Some of the things I say are not even going to be true the next week, and we'll go through these matchups and talk about it. You guys make your own decisions on who you want to start and sit, and you know, I might make fun of you after the fact, you know, Monday morning quarterback style. You know what I'm saying? And then I listen to a lot of these other podcasts, and it's like, I don't want to like drop his name because he's, or any of the names of the people that I might not agree with or that annoy me, because I just turn them off. But this one guy was saying, you know, Jonathan Taylor, looks like he's going to be out like 2 to 6 weeks. And I'm like, the team hasn't said that yet. There is, like, yes, it's a high ankle sprain. He might be injured, and we're going to get there. I forget who owns Jonathan Taylor in our league. We're going to get there. But Jonathan Taylor, if the team thought he was going to miss 6 weeks, then you just put him on IR so that you could have an extra roster spot, because that's a minimum of 4 weeks. The team has come out saying they're not putting him in. They're not putting Jonathan Taylor on IR, which means in their heads, they think it's going to be 3 or less. That's just logic. So these other people that say, oh, sounds like 2 to 6 weeks. You're not a doctor. You're not a medical professional. I'm not either. But I'm not claiming to know the health of Jonathan Taylor's ankle. I'm listening to the team, the Indianapolis Colts, and their doctors say that it's probably going to be 3 at the most, was what they think right now. I hope it's, I have him in some big spots, so I hope it's only like, geez, I hope it's 0, but you know, I hope it's the least amount possible because I need him. These same people are the people that can never be wrong. Like, they never admit that they've said anything wrong, and they make all these guesses, and they're wrong all the time. And like, you know, be accountable. That's why I like Bogman and the Welsh. You know, when they don't win or something, they talk about it. And when they win, they talk about that too. But they tell the truth. They're very honest about it. And that's what I want to be too. Guys, I'm going to be wrong. I'm going to be wrong all year long. But, you know, we're going to try to guess right. And we're going to try to give good fantasy advice in this moment moving forward. Everything changes once the games play, you know, all that. You know, there's so many other factors that go into it. And for that matter, I would love it if any of you guys wanted to call me out on something. You know, I have won some fantasy leagues before, but I lose all the time. I won a big baseball league this past week, which was really cool. But I hadn't won that one in a while either. It's kind of like, you know, what are your credentials? We're all just guessing. So you got to be so, it's a weird stance to take, because you're so high on your horse that if you do anything wrong, like, where do you go from that? Smug takes are unlikable, and giving false information to troll someone or to make fun of them or whatever, it's just a real bad take, and it's unlikable. And I think that we should, you know, look for other options. Like, I mean, hopefully, I hope that you like the way that this recording is going, and I'm hoping that we can continue doing this all year. And, you know, or other people like Bogman and the Welsh who bring a little more fun to it. That's why this is, you know, maybe this will evolve to the Fun to See Sports podcast. Haha. I mean, that is right up my dad joke alley. Congratulations to Tony King and my mother, again, of all people, that knew that the band was obviously Queen that we were using in that trivia question. And it was for the television series The Highlander. They can be only one. There can be only one Highlander. Congratulations. Even if you cheated, I don't care. It's fun that you wanted to interact with it. That being said, you know, send me a recording if you want to be in on it. Or usually it's around 9, 10 p.m. that I do these recordings. And I have the ESPN chat open, so you could chat with me live. I'd recommend not calling or actually texting me, because I'm recording this on my phone. You could email me. I'm looking at Gmail over here. And yeah, chat with me on the ESPN chat. I'm right here. So again, before we get into the fun part, the recaps, and we go through all our matchups and see how we did and what we would have liked to have done, what we should have done, all those kinds of things. Let's just say, don't forget to follow me at Jack Boys or also at Jack Boys Parody Songs if you like the songs that we do every week. I've done a whole bunch of them, and there's an Instagram devoted to all the songs as well. So that was a little extra long intro, but I had some, football stuff on the mind. Let's hit the recaps. From David Montgomery. That's right. David Montgomery, man. He was there for me. We're going to start off with that one because that's just the way that the ESPN set it up this time. We're going to go Preparation HGH versus Brandon Take a Look at Me Now. I pulled it out with David Angel from Montgomery, as we just referenced, which is reminds me hilariously, we were hit with a couple of copyright infringements last time that I had to fix. Sorry about that for people that were listening to it maybe later in the week, like Fahad and others, that were like, you can't play this in this country. Well, apparently you can't play Everybody Hurts, even the 4 seconds of it that I played. That was interesting to me. But anyways, I guess it was Everybody Hurts when we were talking about Shannon's injuries, but we'll get there. So let's look at this. Yeah, this was a back and forth kind of thing because it was like we're going into the Monday night. And I think it has been kind of fun to have the two Monday night football games because there's a lot to be decided in two games. And a lot was between Preparation HGH and my team, Pete and myself, respectively. There was just some points. He had Amon-Ra St. Brown, and he was out there kicking butt. I think he had 2 total touchdowns. I believe that is true. Well, he threw one, and then he had a late passing or receiving touchdown, and that was making it pretty close for me, and I was feeling it. Oops, hit the wrong button there. Luckily, I too had a late touchdown from Pollard. Tony Pollard had a late touchdown, which also helped people that took the over-under in the Miami Tennessee game, according to Vegas.
Vegas! You think we get there by midnight?
Money, we're gonna be up 500 by midnight.
Yeah, Vegas!
Vegas!
Vegas, baby! You know what I'm talking about. We're talking Vegas, baby. All right, let's go back to those matchups. Yeah, they saved Vegas with that last touchdown, Tony Pollard. CeeDee Lamb is great for me. But you know, he was my early pick, one of my earliest picks, and I you know, we expect him to do that for you. What do we got here? CJ Stroud Mary, excellent. It was close, man. It was really close. 75.1 to 71.98 that was tight, man, and I was feeling it. I'm not gonna lie. I was like, oh my gosh, I can't believe he threw this touchdown, but luckily my guys found a way to get through it. I did not licky Gesicki getting me that negative 0.9. That's a standard, gosh darn, the standard scoring of 14 is killer, and these tight ends are friggin' just blech. It just makes you want to blech tight ends. Ugh. You think you're... I got chills right now just thinking about it. Ugh, I don't like it. 75 points was a middle-of-the-road score for me, or a middle-of-the-road score for our league. But, you know, sometimes you get lucky with the schedule and sometimes you don't. That's the way it is. Things will never be the same. That's just the way it is. Next up, we got Ketch Dable versus Mason Crosby, Stills, and Nash. Dable was victorious, 85.08 to 62.42. That's Nikki over Colleen. And let me look at this real quick. It looked like it was going to be an even match looking at projections, but it looked like Dable got closer to theirs than Mason Crosby, Stills, and Nash did. And why was that? Why was that? It was provocative. Let's see. Well, Zay Flowers, see what happens. See what happened was. See, well, Baltimore, as we watch these games more and more, and the Mark Andrews owners and all the pass catchers of Baltimore, listen in. They don't want to pass. They want short passes. They want to run the ball. It is so clear that they just want to give it to Derrick Henry, which, you know, spoiler alert, the parody song at the end of this episode is going to be Derrick Henry related. What else happened here? Oh, see, you had Mark Andrews. So they kind of canceled each other out. Mark Andrews, one target right off his hands and just botched it. Then John Harbaugh's like, he's going to have big games. Is he? Is he, John Harbaugh? I'm listening. Those are real crickets outside. You hear them? Yeah. Yeah, I don't believe you. Zay Flowers, you know, 1 point. That stinks. What are we over here? Oh, Drake London. Still under his projection, but it's still fun to say. See, here's Jonathan Taylor. That's what I was talking about. Jonathan Taylor. Like Jonathan Taylor Thomas. You know, remember him? He was on that show. Yeah. You know the show. I'm not going to pretend to try to duplicate the sounds of that funny intro, but that was Home Improvement, of course. Again, let's hope Jonathan Taylor is only out a couple of weeks. Maybe even just one. Maybe zero. None. Josh Jacobs could be a problem. Who knows? What's his name? Emmanuel something. He's getting some reps. I don't know. 7.8 is still not that bad. Why are they all crying about Josh Jacobs? I'm not sure. I guess they are. Who knows why? Pickens, great option. Elijah Higgins, Colleen, stop trolling Washington. Actually, this goes out to everyone that's trolling. Stop. Stop betting against us. We're going to be good this year, okay? We can have one good year in the last 35. Like, give us a break, okay? I mean, unless you're the, you know, McBride owner, which you are not. Pick somebody else, please, please. It's just like I was watching ESPN the next morning on Monday being like, surely in a 42-14 victory for Washington, one of the top 10, maybe, well, maybe not surely, but maybe we got a shot at having a highlight that's in the top 10, right? And lo and behold, they go, yeah, it's going to be number two. It's coming up. We're going to get a Washington highlight. And do you know what it is? It's his interception. And I was like, all right, national media, like enough is enough. Like he scored 42 points and you throw and you show only his interception in the top 10. And then during his segment, of which they talked about, and no offense to the other teams, this is their choice, but like, you know, they talk about the Eagles forever. They talk about Green Bay forever. You know, these matchups, they get like 15 minutes. Talk about Washington for like 5 minutes, and they're like, can Washington win the division? And they're like, no, I'm Rex Ryan's like, oh, no, I'm still going to pick Dallas. And they talk about, and they show Dallas highlights from 6 days ago. It's like, give me a break, man. Like, just, can we have just like a couple, like we had two great weeks. We can't have a little love that's like, besides, like, you know, us fans and shrewd podcasters, no national love ever. Just throws his interception. What a joke. I started a joke. It started the whole world crying. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. I started a joke, except only I'm crying. Anywho, let's move on, right? That's probably enough. Free Fallin'. That's right. In this next matchup, Je ne sais quoi versus Golong. Je ne sais quoi took their first loss. Golong, Jenna Miller found a way to win 93.94 to 72.3 over Je ne sais quoi. Je ne sais quoi takes their first loss and creates even more parity in our league. I mean, it's not, you know, as we look at it, most of us are 2-2, I think. Je ne sais quoi is 3-1. Right, so I looked it up, and we've got 3 3-1s, 3 1-3s, and 8 2-2s. So really, still anybody's game. A lot of things can happen, especially as we go into the bye weeks, and we really see like who drafted a bench, who's making good waiver wire pickups. Look who knows so much.
Look who knows so much, huh?
Yeah.
Look who knows so much.
Yeah, so good we played it twice. Look who knows so much. Princess Bride reference, of course. We're going to find out, but let's look at these real quick. Ooh, my goodness. Golong versus Je ne sais quoi. Je ne sais quoi, what happened? What happened?
Hey, what happened? Hey, what happened?
Well, we're going to look and figure it out. Oh, be quiet. Goodness gracious. We're going to play the whole movie of A Mighty Wind over here. No, we're not. So what happened? Saquon came back to Earth a little bit. Still solid, though. Kyren a little back. Oh, exactly his projection, huh? When do you see that? 16.4? Gave you 16.4. Whew. Okay, we're going to try not to be too long-winded here. Mahomes, man, it just stinks, man. He keeps getting all those injuries. I mean, it's hard to be sad for, you know, such a great player that's had a lot of success. But, you know, you still want to see great players play great, even if you're not, like, the biggest fans of their teams. Anthony Richardson, oh, yeah, he got hurt, so that was a bummer. In comes Cool Joe Flacco. Joe Flacco going to save them pass catchers for Indianapolis, maybe. Who knows? Rashad White, that's pretty solid. McLaughlin, still don't know. McLaughlin, doesn't look Scottish, but it could be. Nico's unbelievable. I mean, Nico's so good. Yeah, Nico and Jaden Reed, I mean, that was pretty great for Jenna. That was a 1-2 punch that probably couldn't have been overcome over there. Alec Pierce. Garbage for the edge. Didn't come through. Dallas Goedert. Waiting for Goddard, which I think would be a funny name. Maybe a little too esoteric. I don't know. You tell me. Godwin. I mean, this is still a pretty solid score. It's just a little underachieving here for a team that had been overachieving. I mean, you can't expect Saquon to be otherworldly every single week. Can you? You can't expect that. Can't explain how you're making me feel. Can't explain how you're making me feel. Yeah, or something like that. Oh, you guys, we're going to get some copyright infringements on this one. So you got to listen early. Listen early so you get the fun references. Oh, man. What else? Brian Robinson. You know I love him. Brian Robinson. He's so beautiful. Project 12.6, give 17.3. Gotta love that. Here's to you, Brian Robinson. And here's to you, Brian Robinson. Commanders love you more than you even know. Whoa, whoa, whoa. All right. So Jenna wins one, gets the 2-2. And McCaffrey still not playing. McBride injured. This is, you know. This is sneaky. It could be very, very sneaky. All right, we got to go to the next one. I'm your zero indeed as we talk about our next matchup, which is brought to you by the number zero. That's the New York Historians, Fahad's team, who loses to when in Romo's. Who goes to 3-1 and a 1-and Fahad goes to 1-3. That's KC versus Fahad, as I said, respectively. Now, zeros. Fahad, zeros. Now, I saw you at Sugar Freak. Also, you should go see, if you're in the Astoria area, you can go see Fahad at Sugar Freak. Sometimes he works there. I mean, maybe you'd want to call ahead, but he's been there a little more consistently. So, you know, all jokes aside. I mean, he might have had a shot here if he hadn't started Austin Eckler, who I believe didn't even travel with the team. So not only was he inactive, he didn't even go to Arizona from the week before, from Monday night when he suffered a concussion. So hopefully he'll be okay, but yeah, that's not going to help you. Plus, Devonta Smith, also a concussion, didn't play. Those are zeros. That won't help you. Stephon Urkel Diggs did great for you there, 13.5, more than you would have thought. But that's because Tank Dell was out, right? Which we spoke about, and of course you did start him, which was great. But, I mean, what about the other spots, you know? For Casey, 112 led all scores. And Casey scored 112, which was our highest score of the week, I think, which... Peaches and creamed her way to the highest score. Get it? 112. Peaches and cream. ice cream. Know what I mean? Peaches and cream. 112 Road Peaches and Cream. Not to put too fine a point on it. Okay. Hilarious. I mean, we are going to get some copyrights, baby. But that's what you come here for, right? Little pirate radio. Little secret double probation podcast that only we have. This is ours. It's ours. It's our time down here. Okay, moving on. Jaden Daniels. I mean, it's like I said before. He's the hero. I mean, he's, you know, he's Joe Montana, reincarnate, but can move better and can run faster and makes better decisions. Ooh, I'm going to get some feedback for that. Alvin Kamara, he's been great. I keep saying, and other people keep saying too, that he's going to get hurt. I mean, I have him in some spots, so I'd hope he doesn't. But he's playing like a man possessed. Even when they lose, it ain't his fault. Samir White has been a bummer. Deontay Johnson, you got the red rifle over there, taking care of business. Jackson Smith Najigba. Didn't hurt you. Yeah, Sam Laporta. You expect more, but at least 5.3 is something. Oh, man, you started Chuba and Deontay? You're so crazy. That's crazy. It's not that crazy. Red Rifle is making him legitimate, and we love to see it. You bench Garrett Wilson. It's just genius. It's genius again. I'm not going to play that other drop that we did last week, but it's genius. Yeah, because it was in New York and it was raining. Denver defense is good. I like the call. I started Garrett Wilson in two leagues. It was terrible. It was terrible. All right, enough. We got to move on. This one's going to be long. This one's going to be a little bit longer. I'm sorry, guys. We're going to move on to the next one. We got Toe Drag Swag, one of our 3-1s. He's second place versus Byron Pringle McCringleberry. That's DJ Larry Bird. That's my brother, Britt. Still one of the most fun names to say in the business. Okay, matchups-wise, Lamar, always so good. What is it? Jarvis Lamar. Gosh, I gotta try that. Javaris and Lamar. See, I can do it. I just can't do it the first time. But one of these weeks, I'm gonna get it. One of these weeks. Toe Drag Swag. 104.34. Very solid. Very, very solid. But you got JJ, Justin Jefferson, who just catches balls in the sun. Doesn't matter. He's immune. Malik, Won't You Be My Neighbors? Very good. Cole Kmet is better than Andrews. Mike Evans came back. See, again, like a place where I'll be accountable. Mike Evans, I said, you know, he hadn't been playing that great those 2 weeks in the middle. And you know what? I stand by that. He wasn't doing that great. But against Philly, he came to play. And what was his line? 8 receptions, 1 tutty, and 94 on 14 targets. So, you know, like, it's not like I advise you not to play Mike Evans. You know, I did not do, did I do that? Call me out if I did that. I don't think I did that. Mike Evans, down on the farm. See, Mike Evans, you got a nice little drop there. Isn't that nice? You know, down on the farm. I hope he likes, you know, Mike Evans, related to Bob Evans, of course. This is great sausages. You know what I'm talking about? If you don't know, look it up. Anywho, let's go to the next ones. What happened here with Britt? Oh, Travis Kelce looking better. He's going to have to now that Rashee Rice is, goodness gracious, man. That was rough, man. That was really rough, man. I mean, ugh, tough injury to take, especially from your own quarterback. Man, just a tough situation all around. All the Jets looked pretty bad. It was raining. 9-10 is a rough score, man. Woof. I'm not going to go into all that stuff with Aaron Rodgers and the pre-snap penalties, but I mean, you guys can look that up on your own. I mean, unless you haven't seen it, basically Aaron Rodgers is kind of calling for accountability for them instead of like making excuses for them or dumbing down the offense. Breece Hall, I mean, they just couldn't do anything. 1.8, you need more. This is a 14-team league. You can't have these kinds of duds and injuries and expect a different outcome. It's just a real bummer. But you've got some players over there. You got Captain Christian Kirk. You got he's so Bucky. He's a star. We're workshopping it. You know, Bucky Irving. I like Bucky Irving. I think he's going to be great. He looks great too. I like him better than Rashad White. especially for the draft capital you spent. That's his name, Emmanuel Wilson, and of course you own him, so we can't pick him up because Britt already owns Emmanuel Wilson. He only scored 2.7, but they had to throw like crazy. In a game that's closer, where they're not coming back, maybe Emmanuel Wilson gets like 40% of the touches, and we see a little more of an even split there in Green Bay. Josie must have been Kenneth Walker on Sunshine. Walker on Sunshine. Whoa, I'll get it this time. Walker on Sunshine. Whoa, Kenneth Walker on Sunshine. Whoa, and it makes Josie feel good. Yeah, Josie feels good. I don't know if we're gonna get a copyright for that. I tried to put my own little thing in there, as you could hear. We'll see. You know, we're figuring it out. But yeah, Kenneth Walker had 3 touchdowns, and that was sweet for you. And that, my goodness, was probably 29.6 points that really vaulted you ahead over here, over the Saved by the Belichicks. Butker emails go to 2-2 versus Saved by the Belichicks, who fall to 1-3. Let's see what else happened here. Jamar Chase, another solid game there. That play, he bounced off those defenders, and just, I was like, he's just going to score. He wanted it more. Sometimes you just want it more. Who else was pretty solid here for you? Aaron Jones. I'm a broken record with this Aaron Jones fella. It's like Aaron Jones and Kamara and these old guys keep on trucking. They keep on trucking. Yeah, you guys get it. Trucking, Grateful Dead. Okay, I know we've been a little all over the place, but I feel like there's been some good moments. There's been some good moments. Like for Melanie's team with Joe Burrow, 16.28. Very solid. I mean, there's a lot of underachievement here for Melanie's team. James Cook will have better days. Ramondre will have better days. Tyreek Hill, I mean, they got to fix. I don't know what they're doing in Miami. They got to fix. It's like you can't start anybody in Miami. Like, we thought Huntley was going to be the answer. No. Skylar Thompson, I said that last week. He's terrible. He's unwatchable. It brings up the tight end situation because it's like you want Hunter Henry. You would think that would be a better choice. Secondary in San Francisco is not the greatest. It's kind of their only weakness on defense, although it's a very strong defense. Man, you think that's going to be okay, but you never know what to do at tight end. Top to bottom. Who's the best tight end? Who? You tell me, who's the best tight end? I'm waiting. Let's just go to the next one. Oh, and this one was actually one of the most thrilling ones of the entire week 4. The Jordan All Out of Loves found a route to victory against the Hot Chub Time Machines, the Chubbies, as I like to call them. That is Shannon over Ian Strimple, respectively. 95.0 over 93.62. I just had to read it again because I just can't believe it. Let's see. That's even with starting Achan, who couldn't do a gosh darn thing. And Jalen Waddle, who couldn't do a gosh darn thing. Oh yeah, this is, again, it's kind of fun that we have these 2 Monday night games, because there are going to be times when you're going to have all these players on your Monday, like Achan, Waddle, Hopkins, Titans defense, and Jason Sanders all played on Shannon's team and all played on Monday night. So it was like, it was all going to either happen or not happen. And over here for Ian's team, Ian had Derrick Henry. Goodness gracious. Derrick Henry and Shannon found a way to win. That's some, I wonder what the odds are on that. People that started Derrick Henry and didn't win. Whew. Oof. I bet you it's not that. I would say it a different way. I bet you the people that started Derrick Henry won most of their matchups across all of the fantasy platforms. Geno was coming back the whole time, so he had to keep slinging the ball. Oh, that's what happened, right? Right, because it was pretty exciting because Shannon was actually up by more than that, but then Geno threw a last-second interception, and I had to go check the score and be like, did that lose it for her? But it did not. It was still enough to hang on and build more parity in our league, because it's more fun when it's close, you know? We want more 2-2s and less 3-1s. I mean, unless it's me, I'd like to be 3-1. But, you know what I'm saying. Freiermuth. Freiermuth, Freiermuth. He did well. Like, he got a touchdown, right? I think so. Another great recording stuff. Yeah, he caught a touchdown. Yeah, but you never know. Tight end. You never know. And that might have been, like, one of the better moves. Titans D against Miami usually wouldn't be a good call, but Miami ain't got nobody. What can they do? They can't do anything. It is interesting thinking on Shannon's part because it's like, well, then why start Achan and Waddle? Why start Achan and Waddle? Because A.J. Brown is still hurt. And she, well, maybe she should have started Debo. But Debo, I didn't know Debo was going to play that week. I thought he was going to be, wasn't he injured like all week? You have to check me on that. But moving forward, I mean, buys notwithstanding, she should probably start Ford and Debo over Achan. I mean, there's definitely a argument for that. Over Achan and Waddle, at least until Tua comes back, if he comes back. Derrick Henry will be the last song. Guys, we're almost there. The parody song is going to drop at the end of this episode. Gosh, Kyle is the pits, right? It's the pits of despair.
Where am I?
The pits of despair. Don't even think.
Don't even think about trying to escape.
Yeah, I always liked that clip. Again, that's two Princess Brides, huh? Well, you know what? They're going to keep coming because it's a classic movie and it's one of my favorites. And it makes sense when a tight end of, of note, of, popularity, high popularity like Kyle Pitts has a name like Pitts. So it's going to come up if he scores 0 fantasy points. Tight ends, what are we doing? It's enough to break your heart, man. The whole position, it makes me want to think about like changing it so that we don't have to start tight ends. Maybe make it an extra flex or like a super flex kind of thing where it's like a wide receiver, running back, or tight end. I don't know. We've stuck to being real standard in this league, and I do love that about us. We never fell into that PPR, half PPR monstrosity. Well, we made it, everybody. This is the end. We did all the matchups. Sorry this one went a little bit longer than usual. I will try to keep them down to about 30 minutes in general. Follow me at Jack Boyce on all the platforms, Instagram, all the things, Twitter, all of them. I got all the at Jack Boyces. Hit me at Jack Boyce parody songs. Follow in this league if you want to hear the parody song, but you don't have to because you guys get the super sneaky first look at the parody song. The parody song is Derrick Henry's Feeling to Peaceful Easy Feeling by the Eagles. Good luck next week, everybody. Unless you're against me, that's week 5 coming up. My gosh, it's going so fast. You just want to hold on to it and just, they grow up so fast, you know? They just grow up so fast. All right, everyone. I'll talk to you later. Peace out. Baltimore liked it on the evening of last Sunday. Because the Bills came to town. Josh Allen couldn't get anything going, and nothing worked for McDermott that night. We just saw Bills defenders on the ground. Cause we got that Derrick Henry's feeling. He didn't let John Harbaugh down. Cause he's already scoring a touchdown. He already had an 87-yard score. I hadn't even turned my TV on yet. I really needed Allen and Andrews that night. What an idiot I am, right? Cause we got that Derrick Henry's feeling. He didn't let John Harbaugh down, 'cause he's already scoring. Yes, he's already scoring. Yes, he's already scoring a touchdown. A touchdown. Zero shares of Derrick Henry, Captain Jack.